Welcome to the Control-M Automation API Overview video. In this video, you will learn about Control-M Automation API and how to get started. Control-M Automation API enables you to build, test, and manage job flows. It gives you more control over Control-M scheduling capabilities without the need for IT services. You have the option of running Control-M API commands by installing Control-M Workbench on your computer or accessing Control-M REST API from a Control-M instance. Once you've downloaded Control-M CLI and installed it on your machine or workbench environment, you can then build and run the API commands. To define job scheduling criteria, dependencies, and other job configuration, use JSON notation to pass Control-M objects to the Control-M server. Use the Control-M Automation API GitHub repository for code examples and to see how to use Control-M APIs. Using a workbench environment enables you to have your own Control-M working environment. Before you can use Workbench, you must install VirtualBox. Once you have installed VirtualBox, from your browser, enter this link to download the workbench.ova file to your computer. After the file has downloaded, from the VirtualBox Manager, import the workbench.ova file. In order to start using the APIs, you need to check the version of Node and NPM, install CLI, get a local copy of API test scripts, add an environment, and set the default Control-M environment. First, we'll check the version of Node.js and NPM. The Node version should be 4 or higher, and for NPM, 3 or higher. To check, let's open a command line window and type the following. If you don't have the latest version, go to this URL to download the latest version. Next, we'll install the CLI. To install the CLI, download the ctm-cli.tgz file from your specific environment. For Workbench, from a browser window, enter the following. For Control-M, we first need to find out what the Control-M endpoint is. This is the hostname of where your Control-M Automation API server installation resides. From a browser window, enter the following. Next, extract the files from the ctm-cli.tgz file to a new directory called c:\ctm-automation-api. Open a command line window, and from that directory, enter the following. This triggers an action that installs CLI. Now that we've installed the CLI, we'll use the git clone command to create a local copy of the scripts from Control-M's GitHub repository. Open a command line window, and from the c:\ctm-automation-api directory, enter the following command. Now we'll add a default Control-M environment. If you are working in a workbench environment, you do not need to add an environment, as it is added by default. For Control-M, open a command line window, and from the c:\ctm-automation-api directory, enter the following command. We want to set the added environment as the default Control-M environment. This also has to be done for Workbench. For Control-M, at the command prompt, ctm space environment space set, space test environment. For workbench, at the command prompt, enter CTM space environment, space set, space workbench. The environment is now set as the default environment. Now, let's run the sample JSON file which we downloaded from GitHub. Enter the following. As you can see, a run ID is returned. Using the run ID, you can check the status of the jobs by entering CTM space run space status space run ID. The status of all the jobs is returned. We hope this video helped you understand how to install and set up Control-M Automation API. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please contact the Control-M API team.